Hello friends, I am Mr.S.R.Paryani, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, we are going to understand the term green sand molding. At the end of this session, we will be able to understand what the term green sand molding stands for and its extent up to what are the advantages and limitations. Now coming to the content of this session, first, we'll understand what is green sand molding, what are the steps involved in green sand molding, what are the different advantages of green sand molding compared to other, and what are its limitations in green sand molding. First, we'll understand the term called green sand molding. Among the sand casting processes, molding is most oftenly done with the green sand. Green molding sand may be defined as a plastic mix of silica, sand grains, bonding agent clay, water and other material. See, whenever we want to cast something, the molding process involves the mixture of molding, silica, sand. Then second, how the sands will be mixed and what is the bonding agent in that case? Clay will be used, water to extent will be used and other different materials upon its requirement are used. First, why it is called green sand molding? We have to understand why it is only called green sand molding. The green sand molding, the sand is called green because of its moisture content present, and hence it is clearly distinguished from the dry sand. In dry sand molding, the sand is distinguished because it is totally dry in content, which is ovenly dried. Now, coming to next slide. What are the different steps involved in green sand molding? First, in any molding processes, the first and foremost step is called pattern making. Without pattern, we cannot mold anything. So pattern making is the first and foremost step. And in generally green sand molding, there are n number of types of pattern available. So among that, the first and foremost pattern which is generally used is match plated cope and drag type of pattern. We will see this in next coming slide, what is known as match and plat cope drag type of pattern. The second step involved in green sand molding is mold making. Now when pattern is ready, cope half is ready, drag half is ready, first the sand is put into that pattern, ramming of sand is done around the pattern. This ramming helps to develop the strength because whenever we ram it, the grains start coming together. As a result of this packing, sand develops a good strength and becomes rigid within the flask. Then if any cores are required, then core setting is another step which is involved after mold making. After molding of two halves, means first cope half is done, then drag half is done. After involvement of cope half, after making of cope and drag as a different parts, after molding of two halves is complete, cores are set into mold cavity if required. Cores may be or may not be required upon their requirement compared to the part. There are n number of sets where core is definitely required. So immediately after mold making, core setting has to be done. If cores are not placed proper, n number of defects will be involved, or else if core setting is done afterwards, we'll think that we'll try to make it in some other way. So that also can be a big question, and that also can lead to different type of defects over a period of time. Now when pattern is made, molds are made, ramming of sand around the pattern is done to its strength is required. This ramming with the help of water and other agents when total is done, core setting is done, then finally the two parts has to be closed together. Means it is called closing and clamping, which is called also weighing. After core setting, cope and drag are close. Cope is generally weighed down or clamped to the drag to prevent it from floating when metal is poured. I am repeating. After core setting, cope and drag are closed. Cope is generally weighed down or clamped to drag to prevent the floating of floating when metal is poured. Now please see this figure, which is involved a green sand process is done. First, where the pattern is placed, what are the different elements, the cope half, the drag half, the sand. See, the cope half is upper part, what is shown in the bottom figure. The drag half is down figure where sand is done. Clamping, you can see it is noted between cope half and drag half. I can show you here. See, these are the clamping has to be done here. And see, this is the parting line. Here we can see the parting line is involved. Parting line is a line at that place cope half and drag half has been cut off. We can say two parts are to be removed or clamped together. At this part we can see cope half. See, whenever what happens, first cope half when in green sand molding, this is the, suppose we can say this is the part pattern what has been put. This sand is involved, this sand is rammed here. This is rammed, put together, means totally the ramming is done. This sand is green in color, what we are now speaking here is green in color. With have that, it develops the strength because they come closer, the green start coming closer. Then after this, this is the part, cope part, which has been placed above this drag part. Now see, this was the one part, this is the another part, right? After this, when this also has been complete, after this, then we are left with this shape around that. When the metal pours, when the pattern is removed, what is the purpose? This pattern, when it is removed, this pattern will be removed, and the metal, when from flow it will come, it will pass on here and here. This put together, it will make this part available. After this part is available, then what happens? It will be allowed to solidify. This pattern will be removed first, then the metal will be poured here. In green sand molding, what is our purpose? This is, the sand is green in color. The sand is not green in color. The sand is called green because of its moisture content. So this will be removed, and then this cavity will be left for pouring. The metal will be poured. It will be moving from year to year. Direction will be given, and this will study over a period of time that this will be help. This it will be done with the help of gating systems involved. So this part will be produced as it is. Means we can say the pattern what is there is the exact replica of the part what is desired, what is required. See, the clamping is also done. Also, we need to understand this clamping has to be in the proper places or designed in the proper places, because if they are not designed properly, when the molten metal starts coming in, there is an upper buoyance force, which because of that force, this part can lead to some mismatch over this parting line. Many times there are different defects or involved, like some parting line defects or some other things. So this has to be done very properly. Proper care has to be taken in that case. So we'll see. You can see first this pattern is placed, then sand is rammed over it, then these parts are placed, and this is put together again. The ramming is done, and then finally this pattern will be removed, and from this the molten metal flows into this, and then this part exactly what will be required in that case. So these are the different steps. If at all any core, see, we can see some core has been placed. Core are in place. Also, we can not only cores, there are certain chills also required. If certain directional solidification is required, certain chills are been required. Now, after coming talk, we'll understand what are the advantages of green sand molding. The first foremost advantages of green sand molding is most metal, almost all metals can be cast by this process. Second, there is no limitation with respect to size of the casting and type of metal alloy used. Means with the help of green sand molding, any size, means the size is not a constraint, and any metal alloy can be used. Third is foremost important, the most it is economical, because pattern cost and material cost are relatively lower. It is least cost method of molding, what we'll say. Second, the flexibility, as mechanization and use of sand is there. After the first part is done, the second batch can be used with the same sand. So flexibility, cost also will be reduced in that case, and ease to adaptability. Now think for 2 minutes or some seconds, what are different parts around you which are made from this process. Jot down some parts which are around you which can be made with the help, which are the casting parts around you which can be made with the help of green sand molding. Now coming to next part, what are the limitations of green sand molding? Some casting designs require use of other casting processes. The example of this is air-cooled engine cylinder box. So only with the help of green sand molding this cannot be done. The second is the certain metals and some casting develops defects if poured in green sand molding, especially is called magnesium alloy. Intricate castings are difficult to cast. Dimensional accuracy and surface finish may not be adequate, so with the help of another process which are some advanced molding processes this can be avoided. Larger casting requires greater mold strength and hence resistance to erosion that then available in green sand. So even though we can make a big castings, but we have the question of erosion of the sand mold available. Now what are the references used in this is NPTEL, second a book PL Gen Principles of Foundry Technology and some slideshare notes available. Thank you.